Hey everybody, it's Tony from Fit Storybook, and I'm here in Charlotte, North Carolina with Rasaun Rorie, one of the many personal trainers, but by far one of the most exclusive here in the Charlotte market. Rasaun, thank you so much for being here.
Well, thanks for having me.
Yeah, man, so let's get right to it. We're gonna talk a little bit about, you know, where does your love of health and fitness come from?
Right, well, for me, it started at a young age. Whenever I was about 4 or 5 years old, my mom started putting me in recreational sports like basketball, football, baseball, things like that. And it kind of just stuck with me. That way, it was a kind of an outlet to keep me out of trouble and to keep me more focused and into a positive aspect of things. So just growing up throughout my life, like I said, I was playing football, basketball, track. So I just kind of fell in love with the competitive nature and the health and fitness nature as well. And then once I finished up high school, I was fortunate enough to grab a scholarship from Elon University for football. And while I was there, that's when I really fell in love with the fitness aspect of, I guess, the sports world. And while I was there, I got in contact with my strength coaches, my trainer, my nutritionist, and I was just kind of like talking to them and kind of pick their brains about like things like what should I be eating, what kind of workouts should I be doing, what kind of stretching, what kind of routine should I be doing in the off season. That way I can have my body prepared and ready for the next season. And then once I finished up with that, I was sitting with my mom and she told me to like figure out something that you want to do in life where it's not so much a job, but it's something that you love to do and you love and you enjoy it. So she was like, you've been in sports and fitness your whole life, so why don't you use that path as well? And that's probably the best advice she's ever gave me, because that's what I've done. And for the past 3-4 years, I've been grinding and it's really paying off for me.
So how have you been able to take your, you know, experience in athletics, right, and bridge it over to personal training? Because obviously you have a wealth of knowledge and now you're able to, you know, put it toward helping other people create their best selves.
Right. Well, for me, the aspect of things from the athletic world was just to tell people, just to get them to understand that you can do anything you put your mind to it. It's always gonna be like mind over matter, because most people, when they first start off with something, they're kind of intimidated and kind of scared by the unknown. But I always tell clients, the main thing is just to be consistent and just to stay focused, because if you can be consistent and stay focused, in the long run, it'll all pay off. Like, I just had my sister momentarily like a couple minutes ago, and this was her first day. So whenever we're in our session, I was describing to her like the first day is always the toughest day, because it's always hard starting something, but it's even harder to be consistent and stick with it. So I tell throughout the process just to remember her goals, why she's doing this, think about the big picture, think about how your body or your mind can change from this time this year to next year this time though. So I tell clients to always just to have a positive mindset, set small goals. Everybody has big goals, but I tell clients to reach that large goal, you have to set smaller goals to help yourself reach that big goal, because if not, it can become overwhelming and you can like get down on yourself or depressed. But you gotta think about it, use each day to get better at what you're doing and what you're trying to accomplish.
All right, last question for you, kind of a personal question.
Right.
So everyone has a cheat day or a cheat snack. So what is your guilty pleasure when you just, you gotta break away from the asparagus and the kale and the you know, bland chicken? What's your go-to?
My go-to, I'm a foodie at heart, to be honest. Like I tell my clients, I love food, so that's my struggle. But for me, if it's a cheat meal, I love anything from Chinese food to pasta from like Maggiano's, Olive Garden, to pizza. I love pizza. That's one of my favorite guilty pleasures. But I realized since I've been training and working out that my two trigger foods that I really love are French fries and mac and cheese. Like anytime I have a cheat meal, I'm always trying to slide either some French fries or some mac and cheese in there. So those are like my guilty pleasures when it comes to my cheat meals.
So basically, it's fine to cheat, just moderation and setting realistic goals over time.
Yeah, like I tell my clients, I tell them from Monday to Friday, make sure you accomplish everything with your fitness. So make sure you get all your workouts in, make sure you're meal prepping, make sure you get all your days of cardio in, and then on Saturday, treat yourself, because most people think when you're working out or you're trying to be healthy and eat well, that you just gotta cut everything out. But it's okay to have everything, but it's in moderation. So I tell my clients, like I just said, from Monday to Friday, grind it out. Do what you gotta do, and on Saturday, treat yourself. So if you knock out all your sessions, all your cardio, all your prep, then on Saturday, have your cheat meal, enjoy. I always ask my clients the following week, what was your cheat meal? And they brighten up, they smile, they tell me like, because they understand that I'm not gonna fuss at them, because everybody has those days where they're craving like a burger or a pizza or things like that. But the thing is, you can have that, but just make sure you have your moderations and just don't get carried away with your portion sizes, that's all.
Right. All right, thank you so much. I'm Tony Evans, he's Rasaun Rorie, and don't forget to comment and subscribe below.